How long to keep wine in the bottle? Once a cellar is established, its owner will want to know exactly how long he should keep that wine in the bottle. Aging makes it taste better, right? Unfortunately, not always. A lot depends on the type of wine and where it is from. Many of the cheaper wines should be used within 6 months of purchase. Of course, you wouldn't bother keeping really cheap wines in a cellar. A wine cellar should have a wine worthy and able of being kept for some years. So what is a good rule of thumb for keeping wine in the bottle? Again, it depends on the wine. A good Bordeaux or Barolos could do with 5 to 10 years in the bottle, while Chondria from Northern Rhone takes only a few years to reach its peak of flavor. Zinfandel is not made to age as long as, say, Cabernet would. Less than 10 years would usually see a Zinfandel reach its peak. Of course, a lot depends on how the bottles have been stored. If they've been left in the heat, they will have aged more rapidly, even deteriorated. Bottles should be kept in an even temperature away from light and vibration, with an even humidity to age properly. Red wines are usually the ones that age the best. This is due to the extra fruits, acids, and phenolics in it. Phenolics come from the skin that is kept in the grape juice during fermentation. These compounds act as a preservative and enhance the wine as it ages. The skins of the grapes are removed for white wines, so they have less preservative matter in them. White wines, to keep for any length of time, need to have good acidity. Unless, of course, they have what is called noble rot, which can preserve them for decades. Generally, any bottle of wine that costs less than $10 is a drink now variety. This has to do with the economics of producing that bottle. A cheap bottle of wine will not have the same concentration of ingredients that are ageable in it. Experts have agreed that wines such as Cabernet Sauvignon, Merlot, and Pinot Noir can be aged in the bottle from 2 to 20 years. So you can see what a variation there is, and that applies even to the one type. White wines such as Riesling, 2 to 30 years, and Chardonnay, 2 to 6 years, can be aged in the bottle successfully. If you're wondering how long to keep wine in the bottle after it has opened, the rule of thumb is about 3 days. Oxidation occurs as soon as the cork is removed, and the wine will deteriorate very quickly, even if it's kept in the refrigerator. How to serve white wines. Observing the correct protocol for serving wine of any kind adds class to the occasion, and once you get to know what is expected, you'll feel more confident that you have not committed a social blunder. There are several important things to consider, and the first one is temperature. Serving wine at the correct temperature will enhance its taste. White wines should be served chilled, generally between 9 and 14 degrees Celsius. Sparkling wines a little cooler at 6 to 10. As wine will cool about 2 degrees for every 10 minutes in the refrigerator, you'll need to pop it well before you need to serve it. If you need it fast, then 35 minutes in the freezer should do the trick, but don't forget to get it out, or it might freeze and burst the bottle. Some people like to decant wine, that is, serve it from another container, just for the look of the thing, and there is nothing wrong with this. The only time it's strictly necessary is if there's sediment in the bottle, although young wines often benefit from the aeration decanting provides. Whatever the reason, when you decant wine, it should be poured steadily with a minimum of splashing to reduce oxidation. If there's any sediment in the bottle, keep it tilted to prevent the sediment from coming out. The wine can also be strained through a cheesecloth, but it should be done out of the sight of the guests. When pouring wine into the glass, it should be poured against the side of the glass if it is a sparkling wine. Otherwise, it should be poured into the center. Since you don't want unsightly drips to spoil your cloth, twist the bottle slightly as you lift it up. You can practice this beforehand with a bottle of tomato sauce. It works really well to keep the sauce out of the cap. Never fill the glass right up. There needs to be enough room for the wine to be swirled around the glass. About 2/3 is right. You can always add to it later. If you're serving wine at a dinner party, the women and older guests should be served first, then the younger ones, and yourself last. The shape of the wine glass plays an important part in enjoyment of wine. White wine should always be served in a tulip-shaped glass. The stem allows the glass to be swirled easily, thus wafting the scent of the wine gently upwards where the drinker can appreciate it. Holding a glass by the stem also allows it to remain longer at the correct temperature. There are all-purpose wine glasses, but white wine should never be served in a red wine glass.